Somebody start.
She'll come out.
Start it.
Don't pull it, honey. Don't pull it. Just leave it alone.
Miriam Lee.
Start it. Happy birthday to you.
Let me go ring the doorbell.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Antoni. Happy birthday to you.
We're going to have to do it again. Dad, go knock on the door.
Somebody needs to ring the doorbell.
That don't work. Somebody go open the door.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Antoni. Happy birthday to you.
Can we move and like go give her a hug or something?
Absolutely. Oh, Lordy.
Well, you're barely
Thank you. Yes, he is. He's got that little red light on his eyes. He just got that black tooth.
But his watch is still a little
bit. She cut short of it.
Some of the best money I ever spent.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, somebody else had found that out.
The people in here, hopefully we won't be too annoying to the people next door.
Too bad if we are.
They won't ever see us again. Some have mentioned that it might be interesting to hear a little bit about how this all got started, of getting together and meeting for this occasion. And I'm going to try and get not too bogged down in the details, which is real difficult for me. So if I get too much, just start saying, start doing this or something like that. When I knew I was planning to come out for mom's 70th birthday, and we saw Chris and Ruth in Hawaii.
No.
You don't
feeling good?
Kauai, I pulled Chris aside 20 feet away from where she was and said, Chris, you know, I don't know how much capability there would be, but wouldn't it be neat if some of the Abbeys who were close by in California could come over for this birthday, special birthday. And I thought, you know, I wanted to let them know that I was going to be there, we were going to celebrate it, and if somebody else wanted to join in, that'd be great. Well, Chris takes that idea and says, Jerry, about a month later on the phone, says, Jerry, why don't we make this a cousin reunion? He says, I met with Chuck a year ago in the airport, and boy, we really want this to happen. This is the time, he says, this is the time, we ought to make it work. And so then we said, well, you know, who else do we need to call? Well, Chris says, I was planning to call Sarah and find out if, I said, hold on, Chris. I put him on hold on my phone, and I get on the other line in my house, and I call up Sarah, and I punch conference, and we're all three talking to each other. And Chris is going, wait a minute, hi, Sarah, hi, Jerry, oh, you're still here. So we made use of technology, we got it all together. We even arranged a later phone call that we were going to call Sarah while she was at Doug's in Michigan, and I was going to get Chris in line and then get Sarah in line. We had coordinated time zones and what time to call and everything. And
Details.
Anyway.
He got it from you.
I know.
I got it, honestly, I know. Anyway, what... I just thought that we ought to, I kind of planted a few seeds, but are there people who would have, we all know there's a zillion stories in this group, and are there any particular stories that anybody wants to share from 5 minutes ago, or 10 years ago, or 30 years ago, or more, I don't know how far you want to go back, stories of significance, or of interesting, or funny, or whatever, about Joanne.
Oh, I have something I want to say right now.
Go do it.
I would like to raise a toast to my Uncle Elmo.
For dear
Dad. My Aunt Joni, for all these years. 49 and a half years. My mom whispered in my ear that she loves you. And she's darn proud of you.
Time during stories for
I don't know if I have any stories, but I know I speak for all of us here that Aunt Joni and Uncle Elmo and Uncle Chuck and Marilyn have come to our family, and Aunt Norma and Mom and Dad have been the reason that we're all here right now today.
Amen.
And you know, I will always be grateful to, again, as John said, to this man for allowing this woman to come to our home during a big crisis in our family.
Little bluebird.
And I wrote him a card once when he was missing her working, and you know, I had such a tender heart for him and for her, obviously. And the weekends that I spend out here every year for I don't know how long, I wouldn't give those up for anything, not one, nothing. And I'm not going to allow anyone else to come in and share that with me yet, because I feel too selfish. I love these people so much, and they are such a dear part of my life, and I honestly have to tell all of you, I'm so glad they live in Arizona, and that they don't go home in May anymore. thank you.
Details.
I told my dad, honestly, too, somewhere along
the way. No, I'm really screwing up my makeup here.
I don't know how.
the old, some of the pictures. And it just reminded me that once upon a time, you and I were a couple of real scrawny kids. That was back in 1958.
I said, these things are 30 years old.
40-year-old pictures.
But
we were scrawny.
And we were there all the time,
weren't
we?
Yeah.
And we just loved it there, you know. And that's where we found the picture of Bob, Ben, George, and Jerry. You know, and we thought, I think this is Bob.
Oh, it's gotta be Bob.
But I remember this one time, I guess I was staying with you for the weekend or something, and for one thing, every time I stayed with you, you had to brush out my long hair, and it was terrible.
You did such a good job.
I don't know about that.
But this one time, we were at State Farm Park, and we were, you know, playing, and, you know, off the diving boards and everything, and I scraped my knee really bad. And I was up all night crying. You finally came in and said, honey, what's the matter? I said, my knee hurts from patio, and you know, honey. Because I never told her, and I didn't want to tell her, you know. So, I don't know what she did, but she fixed it, you know, somehow, you know. I just remember growing up, you know, that Mom and Aunt Joni and all of us kids really were together all the time. And we were at State Farm Park a lot, and we just, you know, either they were out at the farm or we were in Bloomington. And I remember riding the bikes around, you know, Uncle Hunt or Uncle Chuck's, you know, block all the time, you know, with the kids, you know, and little, you know, burning the trash in the back, you know.
Details.
So that was you guys, huh?
But it was a very good time in our life, and I will always remember it, and it's who we are, and it's like Sherry said, not everybody's families are like this.
Hear, hear.
You know, and everybody, people say, like, what are you talking about? You know, but we're not the same as everybody else.
That's right.
And we now, you know, as we're adults, we know that, and it's because of our parents that we're the way we are, and we realize that, you know, there's a difference, right, Ann?
There's a definite
difference. We talked about it last night.
And it's up to us to keep it that way.
That's right.
You know, pass it on to our kids. I think it's about it.
It'll happen.
And
happen for you. All right. I have one little story I just happen to remember. Seeing these two here together, just happened to read. Trigger a little memory in me. Anyway, they were born about 2 months apart. Jerry is August.
I'm sorry. Got you.
Bob is going to tell me August 12th.
October 12th.
Okay. Anyway, Joycey and I were nursing babies at the same time.
Oh dear.
You know this story. Are you all grown up enough?
We were parked in Fairbury with both babies with us, and we were shopping, and she had to go in and get something, so I stayed in the car to take care of the babies while she was gone, and Bob started to cry. And he was crying and crying, and I figured, well, he's probably hungry. And I thought, well, I'll nurse him, and when she comes up, she'll get your.
Bosom buddies, yes.
I saw you guys top that one.
Oh, yeah, right.
Oh, no, that's great. I never heard that story.
Yeah, she would have loved this party.
Yes. She does love this party.
She was a party girl. Oh, you're
she
right.
Is it's been said you're by right. More than one person. I think
happy birthday to
you.
Yes.
Happy birthday to you.
Yes.
Yes.
To Mom.
You know, you guys, I want you to about little Joycey. This is real special to her, too. And you know how much these little girls like Barbie and everything? we went to the store yesterday and she had her own money and she went and picked out a Barbie. She had nothing to play with, brought no toys. And as we're checking out, she took it and threw it aside because she wanted to buy Aunt Joni the birthday gift on her own, by herself, that she picked out by herself, which is her necklace that she got used. So, but I know my little girl well enough to know, and I have to come up and talk to her, be shy, but she knows how special you are.
Yeah. That's great.
Special to me.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Anybody else?
I think, I'm sorry, but I've heard a story that, and I'm new to the family, and I hope that this one can do it. But you told me.
Look at his therapist. Oh my God, what's coming?
What's it?
Wait a minute. This one will. Would you mind telling, I know your dad died very young, and you assumed the father role, and your sisters were dating.
Oh, God.
Oh, gosh.
Look at that gleam coming in his eye.
No, I don't think so.
No, it was before.
I don't think so.
Well, okay, would you please tell them what you did to those poor twins?
I went out and found them and told them to get out of the car and get in my car and took them home.
And now that I'm 70 years old, I can say I couldn't have been happier to see anyone in my life.
Oh, I've never
right here. I do not want this guy. I thought, how am I going to get out of this? And yeah, like an angel, he appeared.
Well, I had, so this wasn't.
What did you do, Elmo? No. Guys, you know.
That must have been Jerry.
No, at the time, like I said, I get into this and all. I know it was embarrassing, but I was so glad to see it.
Yeah. If I could possibly get this across, I came into this family at a very young age. Right?
Yes. Yes.
And married at 21. And every time Johnny came out to the farm, she just automatically crawled right in bed with Joyce and I.
It was just a double bed, too. No queen size or king
size. I thought he was seeing double.
Okay, Jason, come on.
Here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear mother. Happy birthday to you.
Celebrating this by myself, even with all of you here, I know there's somebody else in here. And we're doing it together. And she would love it. She would love it. Thank you so much, all of you, for coming and making this the most special day I'll ever have in my whole life. I love you all so much.
We love you, Aunt Joni.
We love you all so much.
Blow them out if you can, so they can get it.
Details.
We help. Hey!
Help you out by counting by 10.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks, Jason.
Cool.
Happy birthday. Thank you.
young 44-year-old. I'll be in this crowd. I'll still call myself young, and there's lots of you out there. You know.
I'll second the motion. Of that.
We're still very young.
But I'm going to tell you that planning this event and thinking about what is it that brings us. I know the meaning of life. And I'm going to tell you three words. And it's one that has I've been thinking about for 3 months, and it fits everything that I can think of. It's love in relationship. Relationship alone doesn't do it. Love alone doesn't do it. Love in relationship. Just to see is what's it all about. That's it. I think that's why we have a triune God, right? It's relationship. And relationship, the intriguing thing about that is that relationship doesn't have anything to do with time, although time helps certainly, but how long a time you can have a deep relationship in a day, and you can have a deep relationship the last 50 years. We have relationships that carry on, whether those people are still with us or not. We have relationships that extend to Joycey, and to Norma, and to Paul. Those relationships are still there. They don't continue to grow in the same way as the ones that are alive. Their relationships are still there. And they don't have anything to do with how much money is in the bank. That definition of life doesn't. It has nothing to do with a lot of things that we somehow deem important. What job we have, where we live, how many cars are in the garage. It has everything to do with what Sherry was talking about and what Carla was talking about what this family has that a lot of families that we know as friends don't have.
That's right.
And that's love and relationship.
That's right.
As opposed to give you a sermon on your back.
I gotta put this camera.
I love chocolate.
We debated about whether to put 70 on there or not, but we thought.
Oh, sure.
Absolutely.
She should be proud of it.
Yeah, you're right.
That was a great time. I haven't tried it yet.
Oh, yeah.
I have in my mind that, you know, we should do this at least once every 5 years. And just wanted to get the feedback from you all on how, what you think about that. We have a legacy of a fine parents and aunts and uncles that we talked about here tonight, and would just know that we would want to carry on the tradition of staying in each other's lives. Jerry explained it very well. There's one thing that matters in life, and that's people and relationships that we develop. It doesn't matter how much money we make or have. Is that what we will carry on to the hereafter, the next bedroom, the next room, the next chapter in our life?
It's how big a smile you can put on your neighbor's face.
So anyway, are we all in agreement on this? Is this what we want to do?
Yeah. Five might be too many years between.
Well, we don't have to see each other only once every 5 years, but I mean, if we want to do it every other year, I will initiate it.
But okay. Where do you want to go next year?
Yeah.
How about Hawaii?
Hawaii sounds good to me.
Well, I'll show up at your house.
Well, let's go to Hawaii.
Well, we can discuss that.
Oh, he's going to sing.
Steve is going to sing.
And now I get to Florida Dewey.
Yeah.
close to thee.
I'm Thy kingdom come, thy temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.